happens. Ball's in the air. Here it goes. Controlled by Whitco. Whitco has it to snap. Now she'll give it to Rife. Rife will run everything. Everything goes through her.
Well, she leads this
team. She's going to Xavier.
She leads the team in everything.
And kick.
She leads them in points scored, assists, rebounds, steals.
Yeah.
She leads all their categories. If she doesn't
touch the ball, something's wrong. She will be the inbounder now.
Well, if she doesn't touch the ball, we're playing good defense.
It means she's sitting on the bench for some reason.
There you go. She inbounds the ball. Wide open to snap. Snap. Layup up and good. Zebras got called with her back to the basket and did not see the ball coming in. And first points go to Whitco. Ruff will bring the ball up across the timeline. She crossed the center line to her right side looking for Kennedy. Can't find her right yet. Kennedy working, trying to get open. Dahlquist now on the right wing. Down in the corner to Peterson. Peterson one dribble, nowhere to go. Kicks it back out to Brown. Macy penetrates. Down low to Musselman. Musselman at the block. Spin move. Up off the glass. Nope. Rebound. Fought for. Brown comes away with it from the elbow. No good. Fought for again. Pulled out of there by Cumberland. Cumberland. No run. Ahead to Yohi. Yohi up and good. Not afraid to run the basketball. The Wildcats. And they're up 4-0 with 7 minutes to go here in the first quarter. Ruff crosses the timeline. Goes to the right side to Peterson.
It's a man-to-man defense, but you'll notice Rife playing way off of Dahlquist in the middle of the paint, trying to double up on Musselman.
Peterson double team, gets the ball to Ruff in the corner. Cross court pass to Brown. Looking down low to Dahlquist, stolen by Rife. Rife with the ball. She'll run. One all the way up and good.
We knew she was going to take that. There was no way she was going to pass
that. She had one on three, and she scores easily against the Zebras. 6-0. 6:30 to go here in the first. Zebras still looking for their first points. Ruff with the basketball. Goes to her left side to Brown. Brown dribbles back to the top of the key. Now to Ruff in the left wing. Ruff looking for Dahlquist. Can't get open. They're fronting her. Can't get on the backside. Down a little to Musselman, and it goes out of bounds.
Well, a second turnover for the Rochester Lady Zebras. Right now,
30-second timeout from the Zebras. You're listening to 92.1 WRI and RTC Channel 4. Back at Rochester High School, 30-second Zebra timeout. Coach Daziak not happy with the offense or the defense.
I'll tell you what, right now Rochester's struggling to get the ball into either Dahlquist or Musselman down low. And Rife, I think, is the biggest problem right there. But you also got Kroll, the other 5'11 player for Whitco. They're doing a great job defensively down low. I like the matchup with a freshman, Macy Brown, against Yohi. Yohi's only 5'3". Brown has 4 inches on her.
Kroll's going to be tied out by Ruff. Good job by Morgan that time, double-teaming. Down low, double-teaming Kroll, and gets the jump ball, and it's
first turnover against the Whitco Wildcats. Six. I like this matchup between Brown and Yohi. I think if they can get Brown a step on her and get her a good look at the basket, that might open up the offense for Rochester.
5:50 to go here in the first quarter, 6-0 Whitco. Morgan with the basketball now to Peterson. Peterson top of the key, dribbles with her left hand, looking down to Brown. Brown cuts through the middle, now dribbles to the right side. Looking, here comes Morgan through the middle, and a kick ball, there it is. A little slow. It'll be a Zebra ball on the sideline. 5:38 to go here in the first quarter. 6-0 Whitco. Randy Wynn, Brad Thomas, and the ailing David Musselman.
Yeah, I think Ruff. As I say, I think Ruff and Brown are going to be the ones that are going to get the offensive started.
Got to get something started on the outside to loosen up the inside. Brown with the basketball now on the right wing. Dribbles in, goes to layup, up and no good. Short off the glass. Or off the front of the rim, and it'll go out of bounds. Zebra basketball underneath.
If she'd have used the glass, I think she'd have made it.
Five and shy of a quarter here in the first.
Brown had 20 against North Judson to lead the Lady Zebras.
Ruffed in, bound the ball. Looking, still looking. Going to have to get it in. Finally does to a cutting Macy Brown. Back to Ruff in the corner. Down low to Dahlquist. Up off the glass. Good.
Good job by Emma Dahlquist. She kind of had her back to the basket, but she was able to get it off the bank board to roll in.
Dahlquist gets the Zebras first 2-6-2 now. 5 minutes to go. Snap with the basketball. Now gives it to Rife. Rife will reset the offense. She's at the top of the key against Dahlquist. Slings it left to Cumberland. Now to Yohe. Down low to Kroll. Kicks back out to Yohe. Yohe will drive. Goes up for the shot and rolls in. Not afraid to attack the paint are the Wildcats, and that's where all their points have come from right now is within that paint mark.
Yohe, a senior. She knows she's got Kroll and Reif down low to bail her out if that ball doesn't go in.
Lob pass down to Musselman. Up off the glass. Good. Both players have four. And the Zebras are down 8-4. Reif with the basketball. She'll bring it across on the left side now to Yohe. Yohe, 10-footer up and no good. Rebound. Fought for. Tied up again. It'll stay with Whitco. That time, nice job of Snep getting in there to get the rebound, but Morgan was able to sneak in behind and tie it up. It'll be Whitco basketball underneath their own basket. 4:20 to go here, 8-4 at Whitco in the opening quarter. Reif looking to get it in, does to Kroll. Kroll at the elbow, kicks it back out now to Cumberland. Her three on the way, short, rebound Morgan. Ruff will run, Ruff crosses back over, now will slow it down and wait on her teammates. Gives it to Brown. Brown on the right wing. Get out of there, Karina. To Morgan. Lob pass to Musselman. Shot up off the glass. Good. Nice lob pass that time. Perfectly timed by Ruff.
And Musselman did a great job of keeping the ball up high away from the defense.
8-6. Cumberland now to Yohe. Yohe down to Kroll. Kroll turn around. 5-footer. No good. Rebound. Brown. And she's going to be fouled as she throws the ball away by Kroll.
Kroll going to pick up her first team first.
First of the contest.
Yeah, it is.
3:45 to go in the opening quarter.
You know, you look at this Whitco lineup, you've got one girl going D1 in basketball. You've got two others on the floor that can go D1 in softball. I'm being serious. There's that good athletes on the floor right now for Whitco.
Ruff with the basketball now. She'll bring it across the timeline. 3:35 here in opening quarter. 8-6 Whitco. Ruff on the right side to Dahlquist at the elbow. Dahlquist high low, down low to Musselman. Double teamed and gets a shot up. No good. Rebound comes out to Whitco. Whitco and Yohe. She gives it off to Reif. Reif looks ahead. Can't get it to her. She'll dribble across. Now she'll set the offense up. Down low to Kroll. Kroll. Oh! Coach Stasiak's like, whoa, what was that?
Musselman had the ball.
Yeah.
Just stuck her hand on top of the ball as Kroll tried to shoot. They're going to say that she got a hold of the elbow. But
yeah. Got the elbow. What the call was. Musselman will pick up here first, team first. Kroll at the line now for two free throws. First one short. Bounces off the front of the rim. No legs. 8-6. Whitco. 3:17 here in the opening quarter. Rainy Wind, Brad Thomas. David Musselman alongside as well. Kroll now the second free throw. Good. 9-6. Ruff will bring the ball up. And be met at half court as she brings it across the timeline. Still in that man defense with Reif just kind of floating around in the middle there in the double team. Morgan on a clear out. She goes to the lane up and no good, but a blocking foul coming.
Blocking foul is going to be on Snep. That's her first team second. That's a pretty close judgment call there by the official.
Ruff will go line to shoot two for the Zebras. Tried to cut into this 3-point lead for Whitco. First one's good. Morgan had a great night the other night from Judson at the free throw line.
Yeah, she had 11 points against Judson.
You know, Macy came out in that game and just hit North Judson right in the mouth. She shot early and everything was falling and she just kept shooting.
Fantastic.
Morgan's got her first 2 points of the contest and it's 9-8 now Whitco. 3 minutes to go here in the opening quarter. Reif with the basketball. She'll bring it across the timeline guarded by Dahlquist. To Snep. Snep with the basketball on the right wing. Now to Cumberland. Cumberland, top the key to Reif. Looking down low, now to Yohe. Yohe to Snep. She'll penetrate, go up, lay up, up, and no good. Musselman with a rebound. She rips it and going to be tied up by hanging around Yohe. When she goes to bring it down, Yohe is still hanging around and ties it up. Zebras will maintain the basketball. First sub of the contest coming in for Whitco, a 5'10 freshman, number 34, Verlee Harrison. Harrison will replace Kroll. Morgan will bring in the ball across the timeline. 2:35 in the opening quarter. Down one are the Zebras, 9-8.
Whitco still in that man-to-man defense.
Morgan setting the offense. Come through to Peterson. Peterson top of the key, looking for that post moves from the high-low off the screens.
Reif mashed up on Musselman.
I was just going to say, Reif by herself against Musselman.
Dahlquist down low, in and out, no good. Rebound Harrison. Whitco pushes. Cumberland with the ball on the left side.
Carry.
And
good
she
call.
Carries it. Hence one of the reasons why it should go through Reif.
Right. I think Reif is going to slide down on the paint and try and match up against Musselman now. Since she's got the one foul, they're going to see if they can't get her in trouble.
Now Morgan with the basketball. 2 minutes to go here in the opening quarter. Sets the screen up high on the roll. Morgan now double team, got to get rid of it. Does to Musselman. Musselman, a five-footer off the glass, no good. Rebound fall forward. Reif comes away with it. Reif will push. Reif and the Wildcats on the run. She goes to the hole, up and blocked. But a foul coming on Brown, I believe, as she fell on the floor.
It is indeed on Brown. Her first, team second.
I thought for sure that was whistled on Kennedy.
Brown, as she was falling down, I think swiped Reif's hand. She got her first, and Reif now at the line looking for her first free throws. It's good. ...10-8 Whitco.
Come on. Is that what you're shooting? You missed last basket?
It'll be Whitco's ball to start the second quarter.
Go! quite too late to call.
Back over.
her second.
Thank you. Oh,
It'll be Rochester's ball to start the fourth quarter.
Here. Lexi Brown, that's her third.
Shipper, first.